Welcome to the Solar Truth. Again, I am Adam Evans, and I'm here talking about the Tesla roof tile system today, Solarglass. So Solarglass is finally being installed, version 3, on quite a few homes out there, it looks like. So people are doing YouTube videos, and what's interesting is Tesla has been very secretive about the efficiency. It's all been about aesthetics and how it looks, and that kind of makes sense now, because the efficiency is horrible. Like, really bad. So basically, they can't really hide it because, you know, they're giving production numbers on these systems, how much they're going to produce for the size kilowatts, and then they're trying to make it not sound that bad because they're talking about the cost per kilowatt and then a new roof if you get a really expensive type of roof otherwise or something. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the history of roof tiles, and they've been around for a long time. It's nothing new, but it's Tesla, so it's exciting. So I'll be going over, 3 different customers that did Tesla roof tile systems. They did cost justifications, installation details, information about it, and, talking about the actual savings versus real PV. So, I'm going to have a few other videos that you're going to want to look at, each case study itself that I'm going to go into and dive into. So first, you know, what I noticed was, well, first of all, you have the Tesla launches through the version 3, 1,000 per week. Are they really going to do 1,000 per week? We'll kind of see as time comes. But the problem is they're really expensive. And what I'm going to show is how regular solar is so much more efficient and takes up so much less roof space using your good roof instead of putting a bunch of kind of expensive solar on the back of roofs and these bad angles that are getting very low production. So, it's going to be huge for Tesla. I don't think so. You know, this is a very small customer base that is just Tesla fanboys that do not care about cost savings or efficiency. They just want that aesthetic look. You know, they buy sport cars, not because they're inexpensive, you know, that or Teslas for that matter. They buy them for the look and for the name, and it's something they can kind of show off. So you have a PV magazine actually did an article kind of detailing the efficiency. They took the Solarglass, they looked at the specs, and they measured it and found out that it's 4.9% efficient. So solar in 1954 was 4% efficient back when it was first kind of created. So, and sorry, there's a little bit of noise. My pug, Butters, is back there. He's kind of snoring. And then I might have some emails go off or something, but I want the computer audio for something. So anyway, so when the tile overlaps, you have the tile overlapping on itself, so it's covering up some of that dead space. So that brings it up to about 10% efficiency. But solar modules now, even modules, installed, their efficiency is like over 20%. So this results in really bad efficiency that we were looking at like 30, 40 years ago. So I even did a little meme here you can find on Solar Truth Facebook and Solar Truth Instagram. The evolution of solar, people are like, hey, I'm waiting for solar, the next step, something to, for it to get better before I get it. Well, solar is pretty amazing now. Over the last few years, we've had amazing efficiency results. Silicon is up to like 26%. There's actually some PV that's more expensive, different material that is up to like 40-50%, but it's so expensive, the material they're using instead of silicon. So that's not really an option for people, maybe for NASA and stuff. But now we're back at 10%. With the solar glass roof tile, so kind of like degrading. So solar roof tiles, is it something new? No, it's definitely not. There's been a dozen companies who've done this. This is an example here of a asphalt roof shingle with the Apollo 2 solar shingles, very similar to Tesla's, but they didn't do the whole roof. They just, there's no reason to pay more. It's just aesthetic to cover the whole roof with non-solar that looks the same. That was one of them. Dow Chemicals, Dow Powerhouse had a roof tile system that was kind of similar. They stopped producing it like 5 or 6 years ago. Real Good Solar, RGS, took it over. They went out of business literally like last week. There's not very much competition, that's true. And the reason is because it doesn't really make sense and just doesn't work that well or efficient, and it costs so much money. So Tesla took a long time to try to make it work. You know, it's been 4 years now, and version one, you didn't really hear about. There was version two, there was like seven or eight of them as test studies that were really, really expensive. Took like a month or two to install. And then version three, it's, you know, better, but is it great? So there's a video here where, you know, talking about SunTech had a solar roof shingle that was very similar looking, similar idea. You know, you had a roof tile with a bunch of cells on it, not quite as pretty. The reason, though, is because you kind of need to see those cells from all angles. You know, when Elon Musk wanted to make it very aesthetic, he's having it where you can't, he made it so you can't see the cell at much of an angle. The sun can't see it then either. So that creates even less efficiency at greater angles. The angle that I was talking about, it ends up being a very narrow angle. So when a lot of the solar is on your north side and your east and west sides of the roof, now you're getting a lot of real life less production because the sun can't see it at that angle. You know, real solar, regular PV solar is amazing where it's at right now. So I was actually helping somebody. They were looking at their production on a solar system with regular PV panels. You can actually get per level module monitoring and you know, watch the production. It's pretty cool how it is. And when they were doing this, this shading was showing at the top right and the bottom bottom right. And they were like, I don't think this is right. You know, this doesn't really make sense because I'm looking at the panels and I don't see any shading there. I helped them out, and I was like, yeah, you know, I think when this got inputted into the monitoring system, it got turned around. So I flipped both around, and now this is how it looks, and it kind of makes sense. And then I also did a 3D model in Aurora, this tool here where I can build a 3D house, look at the shade, look at the LiDAR data, which shows, you know, the roof, the heights of everything, so you can make sure all the angles are right, the shading is correct, and everything. So I noticed this tree here. And I noticed it was probably a little bit higher than the LiDAR data, because sometimes that data is a couple years old. And when I played it now, you see the shading is hitting that panel at about 6, 7 a.m. And then it comes across and hits the rest of those panels. So it actually does exactly what that, you know, 7 a.m. does exactly what the Aurora tool or the in-phase monitoring was doing at that time in the morning as well. You know, you have 7 a.m., you have a little bit of shading. Oops, that's good at the beginning of the day. And then the tree comes across those panels and then goes down. And then the rest of the day, then at already 9:30, about 10 o'clock, you don't have any shading anymore the rest of the day. So it really doesn't affect it too much, because the hours that really matter are 10 to 4, 10 to 5 p.m., but you're still getting a decent amount of production in the early morning and at night, which you're not really going to get with a roof tile because the sun can't see the cells. The thing is, we're talking about like aesthetics, and that's why you would do a Tesla roof. If you do need a new roof, it works a little bit better. It's not quite as crazy expensive to do, but it's still quite a bit more expensive than putting whatever kind of new roof you want on your house otherwise. But then you have a lot of people right now, maybe not a lot, but some YouTube videos, they're talking about roof costs, how it's actually, Tesla's actually cheaper. So here, Solarglass, $24,000, and then metal roof, $38,000, tile, $80,000, slate, $100,000 plus. Like, what the, I don't know what, oh, how they're coming up with this. And this is a fairly new January 28th video, so I think the costs were kind of out there now, but this is a, you know, very much a Tesla advocate and kind of promoting the solar roof. In my case studies, I'm going to compare the cost of actual roof versus the roof tile system. And even if you just Google, you know, roof costs for 1,700 square feet, which you could just replace your roof where the solar is going, so you don't have to worry about it for, you know, 50 years doing a premium asphalt shingles and 1,700 square feet, that would fit actually like a 9 kilowatt system. And be $8,000 to $12,000. And even concrete tiles, which you never have to replace, they last 1,000 years or so. It's concrete. So really, you're just going to be replacing paper and repaper, which is half the cost of comp shingles. So now you're down to, you know, $2,000-$3,000 generally. Concrete shingles, even for a new home, you could say, okay, well, for a new home, solar glass will make sense. And what I'm going to show you in these case studies is actually it doesn't. Because even concrete or slate or a synthetic shake or clay even, is going to be less. And now you have a very custom kind of cool, you know, whatever kind of roof look you want. And not all the same, just black glass tiles. So there's actually some videos where the roof's being installed and... watch this here. There we go. Tesla actually says never go on your roof with the roof tile system because you're going to slip and fall off your roof and hurt yourself. So how are you even going to work on these roofs in the future? Like, you're going to have Tesla come out, which they are kind of notorious for very bad service and taking like months to years to repair things and get back to people. So, maybe, and a roofer's not going to touch this thing. So hopefully there's no problems. Hopefully it does last forever and there's no issues, because especially if it's wet or raining, oh my gosh, I don't know, how you're even going to do anything on that roof and repair. You know, what if you got a leak that you have to repair? You can't even cover that with tarp and get up there, or pay somebody to even get up there. I don't know. It's going to be very interesting. That's what happens with new technology. You got to figure out ways to deal with problems and repairs. So this slipping during the install, I thought was pretty interesting. So the roof tile cost, we go back to just this crazy cost. Where are they getting this? So make sure to, watch the case studies that I do and look at the actual cost of roof versus the solar glass. And, solar glass is actually more expensive than slate. So I don't know what they're smoking here.
$80,000 for tile and over $100,000 for slate. So the final answer here is that if you were to look at an asphalt roof and redo the roof with that, plus the solar panel system using the average rates here in Southern California, you would actually spend $42,848, which is just under $14,000 cheaper than what the solar roof costs in this case. Now, I think it's a fair thing to argue that this is not an average roof and is something that is more akin to one of the higher.
So anyway, that is, I don't know where they're getting those numbers from, but watch the case studies and it's definitely not realistic. But the thing is, if Tesla can sell a $2,000, not a flamethrower, this is a propane torch is what this is. In fact, you can get a $24, $25 propane torch online, from Harbor Freight Tools, for $25, build that into a super soaker and you got the same thing, and you just saved yourself $1,975. Thousands of people bought this thing because it has, the boring company Tesla name attached to it. I don't know what they're doing with it. You use it to a propane torch to burn weeds and stuff and melt snow, but for only $24. So the next videos I'm going to be doing are going to get into these case studies and show the cost difference of a Tesla glass system versus a new roof and, maybe batteries if they did that, and a equivalent production solar system and the cost comparison. It's a lot of crazy information about install time, install cost, the cost of actual Tesla PV, if they can even make money on this. See you next time.